It's one of California's highest profile cases, and parole leaders admit they released a convict by mistake. Now tonight, state prison officials are launching their own investigation into how they could have made that kind of error.
Let's bring you back up to speed here. 61-year-old Sara Jane Olson was supposed to serve 14 years in prison for her role in an SLA bank robbery at a Crocker Bank in Carmichael that left one woman dead and trying to blow up Los Angeles police cars in the mid-70s. Then last week, Olson made national headlines when the parole board released her, it turns out, early for good behavior. And now, less than a week later, Olson is back behind bars, and prison leaders are calling the whole thing a paperwork mix-up.
Obviously, it is a pretty convoluted case. KCRA3's Tom Duhane looked into it today. And Tom, how could something like this happen?
Well, according to a statement late today from the Sacramento County District Attorney's Office, it was confusion over two small words, consecutive and concurrent. And Sara Jane Olson's conviction for Sacramento crimes was supposed to be a consecutive term, meaning it was a longer time in prison. Well, the mistake was made by the Department of Corrections. And today, they were really blasted by two leaders here at the state capitol.
Over the weekend, corrections officials blamed a clerical error. Today, Senate President Gloria Ramiro was not happy.
We want answers. We spend over $10 billion on this agency. It's the fastest growing agency in California. For all that money, they should be able to get it right.
This is Olson just after being returned to state prison this weekend. It was a phone call from a reporter which alerted corrections to the mistake. This afternoon, the top attorney for corrections said it actually happened in 2004.
And it was at that time that the clerical error occurred where the two-year sentence for Sacramento was inadvertently removed, and it was not as a result of a court order.
Corrections admits that similar release errors do occur, but infrequently. In the Olson case, Roldan says that applying the 1970s-era sentencing guidelines created confusion.
Had Ms. Olson not been on fugitive for 24 years, I don't think we would have run into the unique situation that we did here. But that's not to say that we don't have a responsibility to make sure our case managers are as well-trained as they should be.
But one lawmaker says that prisons are using early releases to relieve overcrowding, putting the public at risk.
They let somebody like Olson out, and then they realize, oh my goodness, all this political and public pressure, so we better rearrest her. And to me, it's not just Olson, it's just the whole system right now is completely broken.
And late today, a spokesman for corrections said, yeah, we did confuse those two terms, consecutive and concurrent. But they're going to have to probably explain that before a public safety committee at state capitol hearings. By the way, Olson is now set to be paroled 1 year later, in March of 2009, and she plans to leave California right away. Reporting live, I'm Tom Duhane. Back to you.
Yeah, interesting. They only found this mistake because of the publicity over it.